जय जय हे ನಮಸ್ಕಾರ ಈ ಶುಭ ಸಂಜೆ ಗೌರವಾನ್ವಿತ ಆಹ್ವಾನಿತರಿಗೆ ಸುಸ್ವಾಗತ ಬಯಸ್ತೇನೆ ವೆರಿ ಗುಡ್ ಈವ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಆಲ್ ಅಸೆಂಬಲ್ಡ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ರೆಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ಟೂ ವಿಸಿಟರ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಯೂನಿವರ್ಸಿಟಿ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಜಾಯಿನ್ ಶಾರ್ಟ್ಲಿ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಸಿ ಎನ್ ಅಶ್ವಥ್ ನಾರಾಯಣ ಚಾನ್ಸಲರ್ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಸವಿತಾ ರಾಮಮೂರ್ತಿ ರೆಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ಚೀಫ್ ಗೆಸ್ಟ್ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಜಿ ಸತೀಶ್ ರೆಡ್ಡಿ ರೆಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ಗೆಸ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಆನರ್ ಶ್ರೀ ಕೆ ಸಿ ರಾಮಮೂರ್ತಿ ರೆಸಿಪಿಯಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಸಿಎಂಆರ್ ಯೂನಿವರ್ಸಿಟಿ ಆನರರಿ ಡಿಗ್ರಿ ಶ್ರೀ ವಿ ರವಿಚಂದ್ರನ್ ಆನರಬಲ್ ಮೆಂಬರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಸಿಎಂಆರ್ ಜ್ಞಾನಧಾರ ಟ್ರಸ್ಟ್ ಮೆಂಬರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಬೋರ್ಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಗವರ್ನರ್ಸ್ ಬೋರ್ಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಮ್ಯಾನೇಜ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದಿ ಅಕಾಡೆಮಿಕ್ ಕೌನ್ಸಿಲ್ ಆನ್ ದಿ ಡಯಾಸ್ ಡೀನ್ಸ್ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ಪ್ರಿನ್ಸಿಪಾಲ್ಸ್ ಫ್ಯಾಕಲ್ಟಿ ಅಂಡ್ ಸ್ಟಾಫ್ ಆಫ್ ಸಿಎಂಆರ್ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಷನ್ಸ್ graduates of 2019 batch, their proud parents, all invitees, press and media, ladies and gentlemen. Dr. Ashwath Narayan, Deputy Chief Minister, is held up due to some other engagement any moment. He may join us. Dr. Ashwath Narayan is the Deputy Chief Minister and Minister for Higher Education, IT and ED, Science and Technology, Government of Karnataka, and also the pro visitor of CMR University. He is a multifaceted personality and a firm believer of technology. Dr. Ashwath Narayan is an educationalist, healthcare entrepreneur, and philanthropist. Dr. Ashwath Narayan completed his schooling in Bangalore and Shivamogga. Then he went to Kasturba Medical College, Manipal, to complete his MBBS degree, where he became the president of Students Union, and upon completing the course, he became the president of Junior Doctors Association. After working his way through the college as a leader, he was elected later as Senate and Syndicate member of Rajiv Gandhi University of Health Sciences and Bangalore University. Dr. C. N. Ashwath Narayana entered mainstream politics in 2004 by joining the BJP, and in the year 2008 he contested from the Malleshwaram legislature constituency and won the election with a huge margin. The positions he held earlier include convener of Dr. Cell BJP and founder president of Rajiv Gandhi University of Health Sciences, Bangalore. He was also the Vice President of BJP in Bangalore District. He, apart from developing his constituency well, has enabled introduction of health insurance schemes, pension schemes for widows, handicaps and senior citizens, day care center for senior citizens, Seva Kendras in each of the wards. Dr. Ashwath Narayan has graciously accepted our invitation in spite of his busy schedule, and to preside over the 4th annual convocation and award the degrees to the graduating class of 2019. As soon as he comes, I again extend a warm welcome to him, and in his absence also, I extend a very hearty welcome to him. Dr. Sabita Ramamurthy, the founder chancellor of the university, is leading the university from the front with her rich experience in education of over 30 years. I extend a very warm welcome to our honorable chancellor. We feel delighted and inspired by the presence of Dr. G. Satish Reddy, who has accepted our kind invitation to be the chief guest and deliver the 4th convocation address of the university. Dr. G. Satish Reddy, presently Secretary, Department of Defense, Research and Development, Chairman, Department of Research and Development Organization, and Director General, Aeronautical Development Agency, is well known for his significant contributions towards indigenous design, development, and deployment of diversified state-of-the-art mission-critical aerospace technologies and advanced missile systems for key strategic programs and other defense applications in India. He graduated in Electronics and Communication Engineering from JNTU Anandpur and received his MS and PhD from JNTU Hyderabad. He joined Defense Research and Development Laboratory Hyderabad in the year 1986 and subsequently joined Research Center IMRAT Hyderabad, the brainchild of Dr. Abdul Kalam after its formation in 1988. His key technology initiatives led to the successful realization of smart anti-airfield weapon, guided munitions and precision strike weapons. His phenomenal R&D contributions made India self-reliant in missiles and avionics technologies. For his significant contributions to defense science and technology, Dr. Satish has received numerous awards, including the prestigious Science Congress Association Homi J. Baba Gold Medal and Technology Leadership Award, the Silver Medal of Royal Aeronautical Society, United Kingdom, and DRDO Agni Awards for Excellence in Self-Reliance, and many more. He has been conferred with honorary degrees of Doctor of Science by JNTU and many other leading universities of the country for his contribution to the defense field. Dr. Satish Reddy, an icon of youth and dedication, is amidst us to deliver the convocation address. On behalf of the university, I am extremely happy and privileged to extend a very hearty welcome to you, sir.
It is with immense pleasure I welcome our guest of honor, Sri K.C. Ramamurthy, IPS retired, former Member of Parliament, Rajya Sabha, and Chairman, CMR Group of Institutions, whose vision and meticulous planning has been instrumental in shaping the institution to be an innovative, progressive university. In a world that is increasingly obsessed with technology, it is our duty to signal society the importance of art and valuable treasure of our ancient culture, knowledge and heritage. Recognizing this need, our university has identified this year an eminent film persona, Sri Ravichandran V, for the award of the honorary doctorate degree. He was gracious to accept our invitation, and we are extremely happy to have him with us today. I extend a very hearty welcome to Sri Ravichandran and all his family members and fans. Welcome to you, sir. I am very happy to extend a very warm welcome to Dr. Trista Ramamurthy, Provost of the CMR University. Welcome to you, madam. I also extend a very warm welcome to Sri K.C. Jagannath Reddy, the Secretary of Jnanavara Trust. And he is also a member of our Board of Management. I extend a very warm welcome to Dr. Ravi Kumar, our CMR University advisor and former professor of IIM Bangalore. Welcome to you, sir. We also have Dr. Shivapullaya, the Pro Vice Chancellor of CMR University. We have our officers, Dr. Praveen, the Registrar, and Registrar Evaluation, Professor Balraman. Hearty welcome to you, sir. And I also extend a very warm welcome to the philanthropic visionaries of CMR Jnanadhara Trust, and I heartily welcome all the trustees who are present here today. My hearty welcome to all the members of the Board of Governors, Board of Management, the Academic Council, who are with me on the dais, and various other statutory committees of the university. I also cordially welcome all my other colleagues to this program. A very warm welcome to the deans, directors, faculty and staff of all schools of studies, principals, faculty and the staff of CMR group of institutions also. I am delighted to welcome the graduates assembled here for receiving their degrees and also their parents. I heartily welcome our distinguished guests, invitees and friends. I also welcome all the representatives of the press and electronic media who are present. Further, I take this opportunity to place before you a very brief report about the university. The CMR University, established through a legislative act of the Government of Karnataka by CMR Jnanadhara Trust in 2013, is now emerging in the higher education horizon with the vision to nurture creative thinkers who will drive positive global change. Academic programs offered by the university are varied and cover areas of study including law, management, commerce, media studies, psychology, engineering and technology, and architecture at UG, PG and doctoral levels. At present, the CMR University has about 4,500 students enrolled under 28 undergraduate and 10 postgraduate programs in 7 schools of studies. There are 170 research scholars pursuing PhD in different cutting-edge emerging areas. In CMR University, students learn creative concepts and design thinking regardless of their areas of study. The CMR University has adopted project-based approach to make the courses more interesting to the students. So our pro-visitor, Dr. C.N. Ashwath Narayana, is coming in a procession. I request all the members and also the graduating students to please stand up and welcome him. Please be seated. So on behalf of all assembled here and on behalf of the CMR University, I extend a very warm welcome to our respected pro-visitor of CMR University, Dr. C.N. Ashwath Narayana, who is also the Deputy Chief Minister of Government of Karnataka. Welcome to you, sir. In CMR University, students learn creative concepts and design thinking regardless of their areas of study. The CMR University has adopted project-based approach to make the courses more interesting to the students. In order to offer need-based student-friendly curricula for meeting fast-changing industry requirements and even provide credit transfer across institutions, we have recently completed integration of choice-based credit system in all our programs, as recommended by the University Grants Commission. Further, we use outcome-based education model in curriculum design and teaching learning process as recommended by the National Board of Accreditation and also National Assessment and Accreditation Council. The university curriculum has included SWAYAM and massive open learning courses, that is MOOCs, offered by the premier institutions, and our students can select such courses to earn credits as part of the total credits required for the award of the degree. The university has started a few new programs from this year, like BCom LLB, Diploma in Air and Space Laws, Intellectual Property Right Laws in the School of Legal Studies, M.Tech in Artificial Intelligence, Diploma in Digital IC Verification Engineering, and B.Tech Honours in all the existing branches of engineering in the School of Engineering and Technology. The university has taken a pioneering role in mainstreaming UN Sustainable Development Goals in all our academic programs. Last year, saw CMR University hosting the first degree and PU college principals annual conclave, which deliberated on students' preparedness for higher education, challenges and way forward at School of Science Studies. A two-day international conference on current challenges in avionics and space law was hosted by School of Legal Studies. The inauguration of CMRU, KSEST, IP Cell, and National Workshop on Significance of IPR at School of Legal Studies, and a two-day training program on renewable energy law was conducted at School of Legal Studies. My young friends, graduation is only a concept. In real life, every day you graduate. Graduation is a process that goes on until the last day of your life. If you can grasp this, you will make a difference in your life to the society. Before concluding, I once again welcome you all and wish the very best to the students in their future endeavors. Thank you. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat. Honorable Provisitor of the University, I have the honor to request you to declare the convocation open.
This fourth annual convocation of the CMR University has been called to confer the honorary degree of Doctors of Letters and also to confer the degrees upon the candidates who in the examination held for the purpose have been certified to be worthy of the same. I declare the convocation open.
Thank you. Honorable Provisitor of the University, I have the honor to present to you Sri V. Ravichandran for award of the honorary degree of Doctor of Letters. Sri V. Ravichandran, please come forward. Long ago, not very long ago, people of Karnataka have conferred Sri Ravichandran the title Crazy Star in appreciation of his multifaceted and unprecedented works in film. He is known across the country for his ability to balance his acting talent with state-of-the-art film technology. For many, Karnataka is synonymous with IT. But for many more, Ravichandran is synonymous with filmmaking technology. Sri Ravichandran was born on 30th May 1961 in Bangalore to Sri N. Veeraswamy and Srimati Pattammal. Sri Ravichandran's foray into the realm of acting is quite natural, as his father, Sri N. Veeraswamy, was a notable producer of South Indian film industry. Sri Ravichandran started his film career as a child artist in 1971 in the film Kulagaurava. His first movie as an actor was Kadima Kallaru followed by Chakravyuha. As a leading actor, he has several films to his credit. Some of his very famous films include Ranadira, Anjada Gandu, Yuddha Kanda, Ramachari, Halli Maestro, Gadibidi Ganda, Ananya, Putnanja, Sipahi, Malla, Dasharatha, Kanasugara, Yare Neenu Cheluve, Mangalyam Tantunanena, Preetsodu Tappa, Kurukshetra, etc. there isn't a character that he has not essayed, and he is it all with great ill. Sri Ravichandran shot into fame with Premaloka in 1987, which he produced, directed and starred in. Ravichandran is credited with inspiring a generation of directors. Shanti Kranti in 1991, a multilingual film, is considered to be Ravichandran's magnum opus. Ravichandran initially acted in and directed movies produced by his own banner, Ishwari Productions. Sri Ravichandran is credited with discovering the legendary music director Hamsalekha. Together, they worked in over 25 films and created several evergreen musical hits. The music acumen in Ravichandran made him don the hat of a music director and created popular tunes in films like Ekangi and Aham Premasmi. Ravichandran started his own audio company, Ishwari Audio, which later was renamed into Ishwari Entertainments. He is pivotal in bringing digital grading technology to Kannada film industry. Sri Ravichandran has acted in over 125 films, directed and produced over 30 films, and has been the music director for over 25 films. Sri Ravichandran is a rare combination of actor, cinematographer, filmmaker, music director, producer, editor, dialogue writer, lyricist, and television presenter. The dream merchant of Kannada film, Ravichandran, has devoted nearly 5 decades of service to Kannada film industry and Kannada language with very many firsts to his credit. Technical excellence, high degree of quality, precise approach, superior production values is his trademark. He has been a source of learning for several of his contemporaries. His place in the film space finds few parallels. He is a recipient of several awards and accolades. He is the recipient of Kannada Rajyotsava Award in 2010. He is also the recipient of Karnataka State Film Award for Best Actor, Best Music Director, and Best Director for Ekangi, Puttana Kanagal Award for Lifetime Achievement, Suvarna Film Awards for Lifetime Achievement, Udaya Film Award for Best Supporting Actor, and actor for Aham Premasmi, and NTR National Award in 2013. Sri Ravichandran is a complete entertainer who is master at the art and who takes his craft truly to the heart. In recognition of the significant contributions, commendable accomplishments and long-lasting impact in the field of entertainment and in bringing Karnataka's rich heritage to the fore by Sri Ravichandran, the CMR University is privileged to confer the honorary degree of Doctor of Letters on Sri Ravichandran. Honorable Pro-Visitor of the University, I have the honor to request you to award the honorary degree Doctor of Letters to Sri V. Ravichandran.
By virtue of the authority vested in me as the Pro-Visitor of CMR University, I admit Sri V. Ravichandra to the honorary degree of Doctor of Letters.
Thank you. Respected Sri Ravichandran, please address the gathering.
Hello, Namaskara. Honorable Co-Visitor of CMR University, Dr. C.N. Ashwath Narayan, Deputy Chief Minister of Karnataka, Chief Guest for today's function, Dr. G. Satish Reddy, Chairman DRDO, Sri K.C. Ramamurthy, Chairman CMR Group of Institutions, Dr. Sabita Ramamurthy, Chancellor, CMR University and other dignitaries on the dais. As I rise to receive this award today, I must admit that I do feel a little overwhelmed by the gravity of the honor being bestowed on me. I do realize that a great responsibility has been cast upon my shoulders. I am fortunate to be amidst so many illustrious academicians, thought leaders, scholars, and graduating students. ಇದು ಸೇಫ್ಟಿಗೆ ಬರ್ಕೊಂಬಂದು ಮಾತಾಡಿದ್ದು ನಾನು. ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾರನ್ನಾದರೂ ಡಯಾಸಲ್ಲಿ ಮರೆತುಬಿಡ್ತೀನಿ. ಎಲ್ಲಿ ತಪ್ಪು ಮಾಡಿಬಿಡ್ತೀನಿ ಒಂದು ಭಯ. ಜೀವನದಲ್ಲಿ ಮೊದಲನೇ ಬಾರಿಗೆ ಒಂದು ಸ್ಪೀಚ್ನ ಪೇಪರ್ ಇಟ್ಕೊಂಡು ಓದಿದ್ದು ನಾನು. ಬಹುಶಃ ನಾನು ಮೊದಲು ಸ್ಟೇಜ್ ಹತ್ತಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ಅಂಶಲೇಖ ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ಸ್ಪೀಚ್ ಬರೆದ್ಕೊಡಿ ಸರ್, ಏನು ಮಾತಾಡ್ಬೇಕು ಗೊತ್ತಾಗಲ್ಲ ನನಗೆ ಅಂತೇಳಿದ ದಿವಸ ಅದು ಮತ್ತೆ ಬಂದಿದೆ ಅಂದರೆ ಮತ್ತೆ ಅದು ಇವತ್ತೇ ಬಂದಿದ್ದು. ಒಂಥರ ಭಾರ ಈ ಸ್ಟೇಜ್ ತೂಕ ಎಲ್ಲ ಈ ಗೌನ್ಗಳು ನೋಡಿದ್ರೆ ಭಯ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ನನಗೆ. ನಾನು ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಬರ್ತಿದ್ದಂಗೆ ಕೇಳಿದೆ, ಏನು ಸರ್ ಈ ಗೌನ್ಗಳಿಗೆಲ್ಲ ಏನಾದರೂ ಸಿಗ್ನಿಫಿಕೆನ್ಸ್ ಇದೆಯಾ, ಒಬ್ಬೊಬ್ಬರು ಒಂದೊಂದು ಕಲರಲ್ಲಿ ಇದ್ದೀವಿ ಅಂತ ಕೇಳಿದೆ. ಇಲ್ಲ ಒಬ್ಬೊಬ್ಬರಿಗೆ ಏನೋ ಅವರು ಡಿಗ್ನಿಟರೀಸ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಏನೋ ಕೊಡ್ತೀನಿ ಅಂದರು. ಅದು ಏನು ಕೊಟ್ಟರು ಇಲ್ವೋ, ಒಟ್ಟಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕನ ನನ್ನ ತೋಳಲ್ಲಿ ಹಾಕಿದ್ದೀರಾ, ಅದೇ ದೊಡ್ಡ ಸಂತೋಷ ನನಗೆ. ಅದು ಕೋಇನ್ಸಿಡೆನ್ಸ್ ಇರ್ಬೋದು ಗೊತ್ತಿಲ್ಲ, ಅದು ಸತ್ಯಾನೇ ಇರ್ಬೋದು. ಯಾಕಂದರೆ ಈ ಅವಾರ್ಡ್ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕ ಇಡೀ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕದಲ್ಲಿ ಸಾಕಷ್ಟು ಮೆಸೇಜಸ್ ಬಂದಾಗ ನನಗೆ ಬಂದಿದ್ದು ಒಂದೇ ಮೆಸೇಜ್ ಏನಂದರೆ ಯು ಡಿಸರ್ವ್ ಇಟ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರು ತುಂಬ ಜನ. ಅದು ನನಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಿಲ್ಲ, ಅದು ನಿಮಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತು. ಆ ಡಿಸರ್ವೇಷನ್ ಇವತ್ತು CMR ಯೂನಿವರ್ಸಿಟಿ ರೆಕಗ್ನೈಸ್ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಟ್ಟಿದೆ ಅಂತ ನೀವು ಅಭಿನಂದನೆಗಳು ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ಹೇಳಬೇಕು, ಇದು ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ಹೋಗುತ್ತೆ. ಇದು ನೆನ್ನೆ ನಮ್ಮ ಸ್ನೇಹಿತರೊಬ್ಬರು ಬಂದು ಹೇಳಿದ್ರು, ಏನು ಸರ್ ಇದು ನನಗೆ ಡಾಕ್ಟರೇಟ್ ಕೊಟ್ಟು ಎಷ್ಟೋ ದಿವಸ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ, ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಇವತ್ತು ಬರ್ತಾ ಇದೆ ಅಂದರು. ಅದು ನೀನು ತಗೊಂಡೆಪ್ಪ, ಇದು ನನಗೆ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿರೋದು ಅಂದೆ ನಾನು. ಸೊ ಆ ಥರ ಒಂದು ಓವರಾಲಾಗಿ ನನ್ನ ಇಷ್ಟು ವರ್ಷದ ಅನುಭವನ ಹೆಂಗೆ ಹೇಳ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋದು ಅಂತ ಒಂದು ಪ್ರಶ್ನೆ ಇವತ್ತು. ಅದಕ್ಕೂ ಒಂದು ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಮಾತುಗಳು ಬರ್ಕೊಂಬಿಟ್ಟೆ, ಯಾಕಂದ್ರೆ ಎಲ್ಲಾದ್ರೆ ಒಂದು ಕೆಲವು ವಿಷಯಗಳು ಮರ್ತೋಗ್ತೀವಿ ಇವತ್ತು ಅಂತ. ಈ ಸಿನಿಮಾಗೆ ನಾನು ಖಂಡಿತ ಆಸೆ ಪಟ್ಟು ಬಂದಿದ್ದು ಅಲ್ಲ, ಕನಸು ಕಟ್ಕೊಂಡು ಬಂದಿದ್ದು ಅಲ್ಲ, ಆಕಸ್ಮಿಕವಾಗಿ ಬಂದೆ, ಅಕಸ್ಮಾತಾಗಿ ಬಂದೆ. ನಮ್ಮಪ್ಪ ಯಾವತ್ತು ಕಿವಿ ಹಿಂಡಿ ಓದು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಲಿಲ್ಲ, ಮಾರ್ಕ್ಸ್ ಕಡಿಮೆ ಬಂದಾಗ ಗುರಾಯಿಸಲಿಲ್ಲ. ಆದರೆ ಒಂದು ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರು, ಹೆಗಲ ಮೇಲೆ ಕೈ ಹಾಕ್ಕೊಂಡು ಜೊತೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಕರ್ಕೊಂಡೋಗೋರು. ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ಲಿ ನನ್ನ ಭವಿಷ್ಯ ಗೊತ್ತಿತ್ತು, ಇವನಿಗೆ ಸಿನಿಮಾನೇ ಬೆಸ್ಟರ್ ಸ್ಕೂಲ್ ಅಂತ. ಇವನಿಗೆ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಬಂದವರೇ ನನಗೆ ಮೇಸ್ಟ್ರುಗಳು, ನಮ್ಮ ಆಫೀಸಿಗೆ ಬಂದವರೇ ಮೇಸ್ಟ್ರುಗಳು. ನಮ್ಮ ಫಾದರ್ ಕಳಿಸ್ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದ ಪಾಠ ಅವ್ರ ನಡತೆನೆ ನಾನು ಇಷ್ಟು ದೂರ ಕರ್ಕೊಂಬಂದಿರೋದು ಕೂಡ. ಇವತ್ತೇನಾದರೂ ಈ ಡಾಕ್ಟ್ರೇಟ್ ಸಿಕ್ಕಿದ್ದೆ, ಈ ಗೌನ್ ಇದೆ ಅಂದರೆ ಇದು ನಮ್ಮ ಅಪ್ಪನ ಸಲ್ಲಬೇಕಾಗಿರೋದು ನನಗೆ ಅಲ್ಲವೇ ಅಲ್ಲ. ಇದು ಬಹುಶಃ ಅಪ್ಪನ ಆಸೆನೇ ಇದಾಗಿತ್ತೇನೋ. ಅಭಿಮಾನಿಗಳು, ನನ್ನ ಈ ಸ್ನೇಹಿತರು, ಫ್ಯಾಮಿಲಿ ಕೂಡ ತುಂಬ ಆಸೆ ಪಟ್ಟಿತ್ತು. ಎಲ್ಲರ ಆಸೆಯಂತೆ ಇವತ್ತು ಇದು ನಿಮ್ಮದಾಗಿದೆ, ಆದರೆ ನನ್ನ ಮೇಲಿದೆ. ನಾನು ಇವತ್ತಿಂದ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ರವಿಚಂದ್ರನ್. ನಾನು ಪಲ್ಸ್ ಹಿಡಿತೀನಿ ಜನಗಳದು, ಎಲ್ಲರ ಪಲ್ಸ್. ಯಾವ ಥರ ಸಿನಿಮಾ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಇವರು ಪಲ್ಸ್ ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಇವ್ರಿಗೆ ಇಷ್ಟ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಅನ್ನೋದು ಒಂದು. ಎಲ್ಲರ ಹೃದಯನ ಮಿಡಿತನ್ನ ಮುಟ್ಟುವಂಥ ಸಿನಿಮಾ ಮಾಡೋವಂಥ ದಿವಸಗಳು ಮತ್ತೆ ಶುರು ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಮತ್ತೆ ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ನಾನು ರೆಕ್ಕೆಯಾಗಿ ಮತ್ತೆ ಪ್ರೇಮಲೋಕ ಬರೋವಂಥ ದಿವಸಗಳು ಶುರು ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತ ಈ ಮಾತು ಇವತ್ತು ಇಲ್ಲಿಗೆ ಪ್ರಾಮಿಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿ. ರಾಮಮೂರ್ತಿ ಅವ್ರಿಗೊಂದು ನಿಜ ಹೇಳಬೇಕು, ನಾನು CMR ಯೂನಿವರ್ಸಿಟಿಯಿಂದ ನನಗೆ October 18th ನೀವು ನನಗೆ ಫೋನ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದು, ಈ ಥರ ನಿಮ್ಮನ್ನು ನಮ್ಮ ಯೂನಿವರ್ಸಿಟಿಯವ್ರು ನಿಮಗೆ ಡಾಕ್ಟ್ರೇಟ್ ಕೊಡ್ತಾಯಿದ್ದೀರಿ ಅಂತ. ಆವತ್ತು ನನ್ನ ಮಗಳ ಬರ್ತಡೇ, ಅದೊಂದೇ ಅಲ್ಲ, ಅವತ್ತು ಒಂದು ಸಂತೋಷದ ಮಧ್ಯೆ ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಸಂತೋಷ ನೀವು ಕೊಟ್ಟಿರಿ. ಆದರೆ ಕೆಲವು ವಿಷಯಗಳು ಯಾವಾಗ ಮನಸ್ಸಿಗೆ ತುಂಬ ಸಂತೋಷ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ, ನಿಜವಾಗ್ಲೂ ಒಪ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋಂಥ ಸಂತೋಷ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತ ದಿವಸಗಳು, ನನ್ನ 35 ವರ್ಷದ ಕನಸು ಅಂದರೆ ಒಂದು ನಾನ್ ಸ್ಟಾಪ್ ಮ್ಯೂಸಿಕಲ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು, ಪ್ರೇಮಲೋಕ ಥರ ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಸಿನಿಮಾ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು. ಎಲ್ಲೋದ್ರೂ ಜನ ಕೇಳ್ತಾರೆ ಯಾಕೆ ಮಾಡಿಲ್ಲ ಮಾಡಿಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ ಪ್ರತಿ ಸಾರಿ ಕೇಳ್ತಾ ಇರ್ತಾರೆ, ನಾನು ಮಾಡೋಕ್ಕಾಗಿಲ್ಲ ಅನ್ನೋ ಕನಸಿಗೆ ಅವತ್ತು ನೀವು ಚಿಗುರು ಕೊಟ್ರಿ ಸರ್. ನೀವು ಅವತ್ತು ನಾವಲ್ಲಿ ಕೂತಾಗ, ನನ್ನ ಮ್ಯೂಸಿಷಿಯನ್ಸ್ ನನ್ನ ಪಕ್ಕದಲ್ಲಿದ್ದಾಗ, ಬನ್ನಿರಿ ಏನಾದ್ರೂ ಒಂದು ಮ್ಯೂಸಿಕ್ ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡೋಣ, ಇವತ್ತು ಮಗಳು ಬರ್ತಡೆ, ಒಂದು ನ್ಯಾಪ್ಗ ಒಂದು ಸಾಂಗ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋಣ ಅಂತ ಕೂತಾಗ, 33 ವರ್ಷದ ಕನಸು ಯಾವತ್ತು ಏನು ಅಂದರೆ, ಫೌಂಡೇಶನ್ ಹಾಕ್ತೀವಿ ಶುರು ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ಆದರೆ ಫಿನಿಷ್ ಆಗ್ತಿರಲಿಲ್ಲ. ಅದು ಏನಾದರೂ ಒಂದು, ಯಾಕಂದರೆ ಅದು ಸುಲಭ ಅಲ್ಲ, ಅದು ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ತುಂಬ ಸಮಯ ಬೇಕು. ಪ್ರೇಮ್ ಲೋಕಕ್ಕೆ ನಾವು ಹತ್ತತ್ರ ಒಂದು ವರ್ಷ ಕೂತಿದ್ವಿ ಅವತ್ತು ಮಾಡಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ, ಅದೊಂದು ಆಡ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ. ಆದರೆ ಎರಡು ಕಾಲು ಗಂಟೆ ಇಡೀ ಸಿನಿಮಾ ಸಂಗೀತದಲ್ಲೇ ಕೂರಿಸ್ಬೇಕು, ಸಂಭಾಷಣೆ ಇಲ್ಲ, ಆದರೆ ಹಾಡು ಕೇಳಿಸಿದ ತಕ್ಷಣ ಇಷ್ಟ ಆಗಬೇಕು, ಪ್ರತಿಯೊಂದು ಆಗಬೇಕು ಅಂದರೆ ಅದು 15 ವರ್ಷದಿಂದ ನಾವು ಪ್ರಯತ್ನ ಮಾಡಿ, ಸ್ಟುಡಿಯೋ ಕಟ್ಟಿಸ್ದೆ, ದುಡ್ಡು ಖರ್ಚು ಮಾಡಿದೆ, ಲಾಸ್ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಂಡೆ, ಎಲ್ಲ ಪ್ರಯತ್ನ ಮಾಡಿದೆ. ನಾನೇ ಮ್ಯೂಸಿಕ್ ಮಾಡೋದು ಕಲಿತೆ, ಬಟ್ ನನ್ನ ಕೈಲಿ ಆಗ್ತಿರಲಿಲ್ಲ, ಅದು ಏನು ಮಾಡಿದ್ರು ಆಗ್ತಿರಲಿಲ್ಲ. ಆದರೆ ಅವತ್ತು ಆಯಿತು ಸರ್, ಶುರು ಆಯಿತು. ನಾನು ಅಂದ್ಕೊಂಡಾಗ ಒಂದು ಅಷ್ಟು ಹಾಡು ಬರ್ದಾಯಿತು, ಎಲ್ಲ ಆಯಿತು. ಸೊ ಆ ಕ್ರೆಡಿಟ್ ಏನಾದರೂ, ಆ ಪಿಕ್ಚರು ಇನ್ನು ಬರೋ ವರ್ಷ ಶುರು ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿ, ಆ ಕ್ರೆಡಿಟ್ ನಿಮಗೆ CMR ಯೂನಿವರ್ಸಿಟಿಗೆ ಹೋಗುತ್ತೆ, ರಾಮಮೂರ್ತಿ ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ಹೋಗುತ್ತಿದ್ದು. ಮತ್ತೆ ಒಂದು ಪ್ರೇಮ್ ಲಕ್ಕ ಹುಟ್ಟಿದ್ರೆ ಅದು ಅವರೇ ಕಾರಣ ಆಗ್ತಾರೆ. ಇನ್ನು ನಿಮ್ಮೆಲ್ಲರ ಪ್ರೀತಿ ಅಭಿಮಾನಕ್ಕೆ ಈ ಡಾಕ್ಟರೇಟ್ ಪದವಿ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿರೋದಕ್ಕೆ ಜವಾಬ್ದಾರಿ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಆಯಿತು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳೋದಿಲ್ಲ ನಾನು, ಯಾಕಂದರೆ ನಾನು ಇಷ್ಟು ವರ್ಷನೂ ಪ್ರತಿ ದಿವಸನೂ ಜವಾಬ್ದಾರಿಯಿಂದನೇ ಬಂದಿದ್ದೀನಿ. ಆದರೆ ತಪ್ಪಿರೋ ದಾರಿನ ಮತ್ತೆ ಸರಿ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋದಕ್ಕೆ ಈ ಡಾಕ್ಟರೇಟ್ ಪದವಿ ನನಗೆ ಸಿಕ್ಕಿದೆ. ಇವತ್ತು ದಾರಿ ತಪ್ಪಿದೆ ನಿಶ್ಚಿತ ಅನಿಸುತ್ತೆ, ಈಗ ಮತ್ತೆ ಒಂದು ಹೊಸ ದಾರಿ ಹಿಡಿತೀನಿ ಅನ್ನೋ ನಂಬಿಕೆ ಇವತ್ತು ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಕೊಡ್ತಾ, ನಿಮ್ಮ ಅಭಿಮಾನಕ್ಕೆ, ನಿಮ್ಮ ಪ್ರೀತಿಗೆ, ನಿಮ್ಮ ಸ್ನೇಹಕ್ಕೆ, ಇಲ್ಲಿರೋ ಪ್ರತಿಯೊಬ್ಬರಿಗೂ ನಾನು ಇವತ್ತು ತಲೆ ಬಾಗ್ತೀನಿ. ನಮಸ್ಕಾರ.
Let the candidates receiving the degrees rise. Now I will read out the CMR University pledge. All candidates shall repeat after me. As a graduate of CMR University, I will be a loyal ambassador of my university and my motherland, and shall scrupulously uphold the dignity and integrity in my professional endeavors to create the future that will drive positive global changes. This is my pledge. Please resume your seats. Let the candidates receiving the degrees be now presented.
Candidates receiving the degrees, please rise. Candidates, please rise. Honorable Provisitor of the University, that candidates for the degrees of Doctor of Philosophy, Master of Business Administration, Master of Commerce, Master of Social Work, Master of Science, Master of Laws, Bachelor of Arts Honours, Bachelor of Commerce, Bachelor of Business Administration, Bachelor of Computer Application and Bachelor of Science are hereby presented, and all the remaining candidates of these degrees are presented in absentia. These candidates have been examined and found qualified for receiving the degrees. I pray they may be admitted to their respective degrees.
By virtue of the authority vested in me as the pro visitor of the university, I admit all the candidates presented to the degrees, and in token thereof you have been presented with these degrees. I order you to behave yourself in your speech and conduct befitting the degrees awarded to you.
Please resume your seats. The CMR University awards PhD degree, postgraduate degrees in 5 disciplines, and undergraduate degrees in 5 disciplines.
I have the honor to request the pro visitor of the university to present the degree certificates, rank certificates, and medals to the recipients. I also request the chief guest, guest of honor, and respected chancellor to join. Mr. Lokesh Gowda, PhD in Computer Science. Ms. Shweta PA, PhD in Commerce. Ms. Geetanjali Patel, PhD in Economics. Mr. Janaswamy Rajshekar, CMR Gold Medal and First Rank in Executive Master of Business Administration in Product Leadership. I request Honorable Chief Guest Dr. G. Satish Reddy to award the medals. Ms. Pavana Bevi, CMR Gold Medal, First Rank in MBA Program. Ms. Priyadarshini H., she has got 2 gold medals, CMR Gold Medal in MCOM and International Skill Development Cooperation Program, and also First Rank in Master of Commerce. Ms. Rakhi Jayaprakash L., CMR Gold Medal in MSW Program. Ms. Mishra K. Madhu, CMR Gold Medal and First Rank in MSc Psychology Clinical Program. Ms. Akula Sudeshna Gupta, CMR Gold Medal and First Rank in MSc Psychology, Human Resource and Development and Management Program. Mr. Anish Day, CMR Gold Medal and First Rank in Master of Laws Program in Commercial Law Specialization. Ms. Nihan Ahmed, CMR Gold Medal and First Rank and Master of Laws in Constitutional Law Program. I request Chancellor Madam to award the medals and degree certificates. Mr. Somshekhar P., CMR Gold Medal and First Rank in Bachelor of Commerce Program. Ms. Shweta R., CMR Gold Medal and First Rank in Bachelor of Commerce Program. Ms. Crystal Chakrabarti, CMR Gold Medal and First Rank in BCom Honors in International Accounting and Finance. Mr. Akash N., CMR Gold Medal and First Rank in Bachelor of Commerce Honors in Risk and Management Accounting. I request our guest of honor, Shri K.C. Ramamurthy sir, to award the degrees. Ms. Ashishwini P., CMR Gold Medal and First Rank in BA Honors Program. Mr. Prapujia Ramesh, CMR Gold Medal and First Rank in BSc Sound Engineering. Mr. Ashwin K, CMR Gold Medal and First Rank in BCA Game and Mobile Software Development. And finally, Mr. Rohan SP, CMEDU Gold Medal for Outstanding Student for Holistic Development among all UG programs of 2016 batch.
Respected Dr. G. Satish Reddy, I have the honor to request you to kindly deliver the convocation address.
Honorable Pro Visitor of the University, Dr. Ashwata Narayan, Honorable Chancellor of the University, Srimati Savita Ramamurthy, Guest of Honor, Shri Ramamurthy, Vice Chancellor of the University, Professor Shivakumar, the other dignitaries who are present on the dais, particularly Professor Vasagam and others, and other eminent personalities who are present here. Most important people of the day, the students who are passing out of their respective courses today out of the university, and the parents, media. Very good evening to each and every one of you here. At the outset, let me thank the university for inviting me here to give the convocation address on the occasion of the fourth convocation of this CMR University here. And also, my heartiest congratulations to all the students who are receiving the respective degrees in the respective courses, and also congratulations to all the gold medal winners of today, what they have received from the Honorable Deputy Chief Minister of Karnataka. Friends, it's an important day in your life. You are walking out of the academic university into the society. The way you conduct tomorrow onwards, that reflects the university. The university, the professors who have taught you, who have imparted you the knowledge, will be happy once you put forth this knowledge, what you gained here, into practice and excel yourself in life. That's the day the professors here, the teachers who have taught you, will be very happy. Any alumni of any university, when he reaches a top position or when he achieves something, that's the day university celebrates. All of you have seen many personalities who have excelled in their lives and who have become CEOs of great companies, or who have become great doctors, engineers, scientists, or whatever it is. That's the day the university has celebrated that my student has achieved this in his life. So that's why I'm saying it is very important. Tomorrow onwards, how you conduct yourself and what you achieve in your life is very important for you and also to the university. Friends, universities play a major role in the growth of any nation. Let me again repeat, universities play a major role in the growth of any nation. Present day, any nation's economically becoming stronger or prosperous, it's out of primarily the technologies. a country which has excelled itself in technologies, who have produced state-of-the-art systems. They have become economically very strong nations. Look at the examples of whether it is Japan or Israel. I am not taking the Western world at all. I am talking about whether it is Japan or talk about Israel or even Korea or even the example of Finland, the country which has suffered a lot after the fall of USSR, regenerated itself out of technological achievement by youngsters of that country. They were not knowing what to do, how to revive the economy of the nation. That's the time the youngsters have come out with ideas and made products which sold all over the world. So, technologies play a major role in the nation's building. If technologies play a major role in building those technologies, universities play a major role. Universities are the engines of innovations today. Innovations are the most important today in any country's growth. The government is giving so much importance to the innovations today. Many schemes have been brought in, whether it is right from the school days, Atal Innovation, or talk about later, the final year students, college students, or the startups. Many schemes have been brought up to promote innovation, whether it is a scheme called IDEX, or scheme called TDF, or it is Kalam's Dare to Dream, or DST schemes, or CSK schemes. Many things have been brought to promote innovations today. Friends, it is not like earlier days where the youngsters were showing interest only in the ICT, the information communication technology. We have excelled ourselves. India has captured the opportunities in the information technology area, and we have shown to the world that our capabilities in many areas. But then, we were not doing that well in other areas. But the scenario has changed a lot. Youngsters are showing lots of interest in many technology areas. Lots of technologies, right from material technology, propulsion technology, aerospace engineering, what not you talk today, the number of startups which are coming up in the country today. Last 4 years I have seen the way the startups have come in the area of defense technology itself shows how the youth are showing interest in this area. About 7 years back, I went to NIT Warangal, which has a very strong department in the Department of Metallurgy. And out of the 40 students that class had in the final year, 38 of the students from Metallurgy department have joined the IT industry. 38 of the Metallurgy students. I don't find fault with the Metallurgy students at all. That was the situation that day. The opportunities were there only in the IT industry. Today the scenario has changed. Many people are coming out and working in the Metallurgy area. There is a boy here in Bangalore who has a startup in IISc. When he was in final year engineering itself, he was working with the propulsion technologies, rocket motors, rocket boosters he was working. In fact, he has burnt his finger, his hand on the while doing the experiments, just at the age of 21 years. And he met me. I talked to the then ISRO chairman Kiran Kumar. He is interested in developing the propulsion technologies. That young boy, the ISRO gave him a 2 crores worth of project. And very successfully, within 2 years, he developed a propulsion technologies for interplanetary motion based on water. Successfully accepted by ISRO, a youngster, 23 years old boy. Now, he has established now his startup in IISc. The French government is collaborating with him for the green propulsion technologies today. Youngster, still about 24 years old boy. Last year, a student who passed out met me saying that I want to work on materials which are required for the missiles, very high temperature materials, composite materials. Basically, we use for the rocket motors, composite rocket motor casings and all that, for that materials which are required. I introduced him to our scientist saying that he wants to establish an industry, you give him some work and he will be supplying those items. That boy next day came to me, sir, I did not come to you to get a work. I want to develop some new materials, so I wanted a help from your people. So I introduced some of the retired scientists who have knowledge in this area. 3 months back he met me, he developed a composite material for the rocket motor, which can withstand 300 degrees more temperature than the material what we already have. A boy of about 24 years old. This is the type of materials what people are developing in the country, youngsters. I met another boy in Mumbai. He makes rodent repellents, supplies all over the NATO countries. In fact, we wrote to United States of America somewhere in the country saying that we want rodent repellents. We got a reply back saying that, Ari Baba, we are also buying from India, this is the address, you take it from this boy who is supplying to us all over the country, all over the world. So that is the type of a innovations what are coming in the country today. Youth are doing exceedingly well. There are lots of opportunities which are created in the government today. It is not like earlier days where everyone who is passing out of the college has to look for a job. Come out, establish industries, startups. There are so many opportunities which are given. Look at our DRDO website. We have put about 136 problems in our website. If you come out with a solution, if you find really it is a viable solution, the complete development we are going to fund it. That's how the schemes are there. The mini schemes which have been introduced, which you can come out and excel. The only thing, we have to come out with an innovative product. The product should not be a routine product. If this country has to be a very prosperous nation, we have to build the systems which actually the world looks at. We have built many technologies, many missions which are complex missions. I will only give one example of what we have done on 27th of March this year. 27th of March this year, the DRDO has developed one mission which has gone into the low Earth orbit and hit a satellite and destroyed it. Let me tell you the complexity of the mission. A satellite which is orbiting with a velocity of about 7.8 kilometers per second and the missile which is traveling is about 3.2 kilometers per second and the total velocity, relative velocity between the two is about 11 kilometers per second and a small object of 1.2 meters by 1.3 meters the missile has tracked it, gone into the space and seen at 300 kilometers altitude and there was no explosive or anything. It has gone directly hit just 6 centimeters away from the center of its geometric center of that object and has hit it. The world, entire world started applauding. And we became the fourth nation in the world who have done such an experiment. It is America, Russia and China and India. And we as a responsible nation, we have done it at low Earth orbit so that the debris created are minimum and the effects are minimum. That is the complexity of such a mission. After such a mission, no one has said anything against us and in fact appreciated the technological capability of the country. I want to mention here one thing. When you are weak, people mock at you. And if you are strong, the same people admire you. I'll give you one example. Before Agni 5 missile test, which is a intercontinental ballistic missile test, the people thought that we will not be able to develop, stopped supplying many of the critical components to India and thought we will not be able to do. But of the successful mission of Agni 5, see the responses of the two countries I'll mention just now. China has said that it is not just 5,000 kilometers, that missile has the capability for more than 8,000 kilometers, that we are aware. America said, we very well know the capabilities of Indians. They can achieve this type of a technological marvels. And we also know that they are very peace-loving people. This is the statement what is given by America. So the same people admire you when you become stronger. So we need to become stronger technologically. We need to create lots of systems which world has not seen. Dr. Kalam, who is our guru, continuously used to say, when we have developed many systems, whenever we become one of the fifth nation, sixth nation in the world developing varieties of systems, try to develop first of its kind systems in the world. That's what his dream. In fact, when he was there, he has achieved one thing like that. A BrahMos missile which was developed during his period, that was the only supersonic missile in the entire world where India and only Russia who jointly developed have got. No other country has got such a weapon. And so entire world is looking towards BrahMos missile now. Why don't we supply it to our countries? If this country has to become rich, if this country has to become prosperous, we have to develop technologies which world looks for it. That technologies have to be the first of its kind technologies. If we have to develop the first of its kind technologies, the universities have to be very strong here in the country. You have to be very strong academically. You have to do the basic roots research in the academic institutes, which will be taken up by organizations like us, which will do the translational research, and the industry produces it with quality. So the universities have to be stronger. If you have to develop first of its kind systems in the world, I also need to have universities which stand in the first ranking of the world also. So we need to do such great research in the academic institutes, which the lead of which is taken by the R&D organizations and the industry, and can produce systems which world has not seen. If world has to buy systems from us, the systems have to be the state of the art, or the advanced systems, or the first of its kind systems, then only they will buy you. Friends, let me tell you, we have been technology followers till today. That means somebody develops a technology, we start working on it, maybe 5 years to 10 years later, we develop that system here indigenously, and then we become self-reliant. This doesn't work. If I make a system, probably I will be able to supply to my own armed forces here in the defense. But I need to supply to the world if the country has to become rich. If you have to supply to the world, then you have to be the technology leader, not the technology follower. If you have to be the technology leader, then the basic research has to come from the academic institutes. And taking the lead of it, you have to come out with innovative products. Then the world buys from you. You have to supply a system which is really advanced in nature, futuristic in nature, which is innovative, which has got a quality, sustained quality, and which has that the price is low compared to the other products which are available. Then the entire world buys from you. For this, the academic institutes, the R&D organizations like us, DRDO and others, and the industry has to work in a synergetic manner here. The industry also has to do research in niche areas. That's why we are promoting industry in a big way. Recently, friends, I have about more than 1500 patents with my organization. We made it open. You can see the website. All these 1500 patents you can see. You select what is suitable to you. We support you. We handhold you and give you the support. We started giving our technology transfer to industry with zero fee. No technology transfer fee at all. And we are also taking private industry people as our partners today in development of even critical systems like missiles. Let me tell you today, Akash missile has got about 29,000 crores of orders. 29,000 crores of orders. And for that missile, if BDL is producing that missile, 87% by value are coming from private industry. That is the contribution the private industry is doing today. When we started developing in the 80s missiles, there must not have been not more than 20-30 industries working with us. Today we have about 1800 industries which are working with us. So country has to grow industrially. But not just supplying to DRDO or armed forces or railways here. We need to supply to the world. And then the country becomes prosperous. So youngsters who are walking out of this university today, use the knowledge what is imparted by the learned professors here. Come out with innovative products, innovative technologies, innovative patents, and then the world looks at you. You will be able to supply to the entire world. And that is the only way this country becomes prosperous. And if you want this country's flag flying over the top of the world, you people who are the youngsters on which the country has got lots of hopes, you have to come out with innovative technologies. For that, you need to be very sincere, hardworking, dedicated to yourself. Remember the words of Dr. Kalam. He used to say always, dream, dream, dream. You should dream that I will become a famous man. You should dream that I will achieve something great in the life. I will do something great to the nation. That dream will never allow you to sleep. You will always be working hard. If you have that determination, come out with a product which you will be remembered for. Your name should be remembered for that product, which brings name to this country, which makes this country prosperous. That is what youth of the country should look. That is the only way this country becomes prosperous. All the best. God bless you.
Thank you, sir. Honorable Provisitor of the University, I have the honor to request you to deliver the presidential address.
Namaskara. On the occasion of the CMR University 4th Annual Convocation, I would like to acknowledge the presence of our Honorable Chief Guest, Dr. Satish Reddy, who is the Secretary for Defense Research and Development and Chairman for the DRDO. And at the same time, I acknowledge the presence of our Chancellor, Dr. Sabita Ramurthy Reddy, Honorable Guest, Mr. Ramurthy, IPS officer, and a former Rajya Sabha member, and all other dignitaries on the dais, and my good friend, and I am also a fan of Sri Ravichandra, V. Ravichandra. Almost I have seen and watched all of your movies, sir. I have been a ardent fan of yours. You have been an inspiration for our Karnataka and Karnataka film industry. Your immense contribution has been very muchly recognized, acknowledged by the people of Karnataka and also today by our CMR University. I would like to congratulate once again and dignitaries of the dais, respected parents, faculty members, dear graduates, for the many years of hard work. Today is the day you have been awarded degrees and postgraduate degrees for the, all the hard work. I would like to congratulate all of you on this occasion. And at the same time, I would like to acknowledge the immense contribution of the founders of the CMR University, the kind of facility what they have developed, they have built over the years, has brought a reputation for Karnataka, and in the field of education, they have made a big difference by their immense contribution in the field of education, has resulted in the growth of the industry in the state of Karnataka and in the nation. So I would like to congratulate your dedication, your contribution to the, our country, madam, and your entire team I would like to congratulate. And as all of you know, Bangalore is a city of cosmopolitan. Here people from across the country, across the world, they live in the city of Bangalore. Bangalore has been the home for all kind of people from different regions, different parts of the world. Bangalore has been an attraction
Bangalore is a place everybody would love to do business, study and live here. And as Bangalore city has been recognized across the world for its contribution in the field of IT/BT, science and technology, aerospace, defense, many sectors in our country, Bangalore has been the center of learning and center of innovation and center for knowledge and technology. Since that being the case, Bangalore is a place where we need to take it to a further level. We need to keep pace with the changes happening across the world. We are competing not just with our surrounding state, we need to compete with the entire world. That being the case, the pursuit of excellence, the quality which we need to provide, infrastructure and many other things related to the education or the industry, has been very challenging. In this process, to some extent we have been successful. We need to move further and provide the best possible infrastructure and best possible system, ecosystem, such that it can cater to all of your requirement and build your better future, so that your dreams will come true, all your parents' dream and your well-wishers and your dream needs to come true. If you want to thrive outside, once you have all this time you have been taken care by your family and your well-wishers and by CMR institution, what next after passing out from this institution? That's a more important phase where you will be undergoing a lot of challenges. To address this concern, under the leadership of our Honorable Prime Minister, in the past 5.5 years, he has brought in a lot of structural reforms. Structural reforms, not just reforms, a solid structural reforms wherein the entire country can progress very effectively. We went through a lot of pain and a lot of challenges, and we have still been going through all these challenges. But the kind of reforms what has been brought in will be benefited such a way that the system can allow us to thrive and grow in a very strong, even very, very strong way, and it will be a guaranteed system. Otherwise, if and buts will be there, normally ifs and buts, depending on the person we have been ruled. But here is a system where the system has been built such a way that the foundation is very, very strong. Any one of us can construct our house or construct our business, construct our entrepreneurship and build our better future. So this kind of a strong foundation is going to make a big difference. And added to that, in the state of Karnataka, under the leadership of our Honorable Chief Minister, the state of Karnataka has been recognized by the Niti Aayog as the number one state in the field of innovation. In the field of innovation and academia and industry linkage. Even in the field of education, the linkage between the industry and the academia, our state has been the number one for the linkage of the industry and the academic. This has been a real good achievement. This small collaboration also can bring in a big changes. CMR University, when I went through the lot of collaboration happening in the CMR University, collaborating with many of the universities across the world, with many of the companies and many of the startups and many other good initiatives been taken up by many NGOs, has made a big difference. Their collaboration, they have never missed any opportunity wherever they can partner with any of the good institution or the partners, so that it can bring in lot of good changes, or some progressive decision can be taken, or progressive changes can be brought in. So Each one of us need to be aware of the responsibility which we hold. In this process, CMR has done its best, and you also have done your best throughout your career, which has resulted in getting the degrees today. The further journey needs to be taken in a very strong way, determined, so that you will be passing and facing a lot of challenges in the outside world to make your future and your dreams to come true, and we'll be coming out with many more changes that is in the policies and in programs. And in the state of Karnataka, we are coming out with an innovative authority. The innovative authority will be the biggest game changer in the state of Karnataka, and we'll be the first state to come out with an innovative authority, not only in the state of Karnataka, India, in India, across world. We'll be the first state, even across the world, to come out with an innovative authority. We have seen and heard in isolation, in particularly one particular field, they have come out with regulatory sandboxes. But coming out with a regulatory sandbox across all the fields is not been seen or heard. We'll be the first state in the entire world to come out with an innovative authority, so that the law doesn't come in the way of the innovation and the changes. Whatever a person, entrepreneur, is interested to bring in, there will not be any obstruction in the law, and we'll be completely facilitating new innovation through these kind of authorities, sharing this few of the initiatives. And we'll be, at present we have many programs like Elevate, Grand Challenge, New Age Incubation Centers, Center of Excellence, many more initiatives we have taken up, and we have come out with many programs where entrepreneurship can be celebrated, encouraged, and we'll be supporting your bright future through many more initiatives, and we'll make sure that state of Karnataka will be the best place to conduct business, and the ease of doing business also we are given a lot of priority. Probably in a matter of time, the changes and the reforms will be bringing in our state of Karnataka, and our state will be the best place to conduct business. The ease of doing business will encourage the entrepreneurs from across the world to come and invest in the state of Karnataka. By doing this, we can ensure we'll be getting better opportunities as an employer or as an employee, so that you can become more productive and you should get a better opportunity. Saying these few words, I would like to thank the organizers for giving me this opportunity, and I thank all the parents and students at this juncture. I wish you all the best. Thank you, one and all.
Sorry, during my address, made a mistake, forgot Dr. Ravichandran. My heartiest congratulations to you for getting honorary degree. Sorry for my mistake. God bless you with many more awards, many more achievements. Make people more entrepreneuring, make happy in life. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Honorable Provisitor of the University, I request you to dissolve the convocation, please.
I declare this convocation dissolved.
All may please rise for the national anthem.
Oh,
Kundalahalli, who has achieved the third rank. Ravi Kiran P. S. Ravi Shankar, S. Vinod Kumar, Sandeep Rajan P. Shreyas Kian, Sridhar Bharat Rajan, Tarun Agarwal, who has achieved the second rank.
Vikas KV. Vaidya Dipali. Rahul Devidas. Now I request the students of Masters of Business Administration degree recipients to kindly follow the line. I request the students of the EMBE program to kindly come on stage for a quick photograph. I repeat, the students of the EMBE program to kindly come on stage for a quick photograph. Bojamma CV. Chandan Kumar PG. Chowda Reddy GC. Deepak M. Students, kindly give a round of applause. Dipali Chavan R, who's achieved the 5th rank. Feba C. Kevin Jose. Gautam S. Hamsa Jawal. Mm-hmm. Harinath N. Imini Ritwik. K. Harsha Kumari. Karthik, Kalyan Kumar, Kavana HM. Rishabh Sanjay. Mamta N. Manoj P. Mohammed Gayaz. Muhammad Danish Shoaib. Muhammad Fahim. And Shweta, Nayana MS, Nikhil K. Padma P. Prashant Kumar M. Rakesh Rao. Ramu P. Ramya Lakshmi. Rashmita S.R. Shivprasad D.V. Sharprasad D.V. Shivprasad Devi. Syed Burhanuddin Ahmed, who has achieved the fourth rank. Syed Sadat. Thomas Dominic. Vani HV. Vignesh V. Vikram Reddy D. Vishal Antony, who's achieved the third rank. Dinesh. Kirtana. Priyanka E. Pushpa S. Pushpa Renu Joseph. Rizwan S. Sanjana C. Vaishnava S.A. The MCOM students, can you come on stage quickly for a quick class photograph? The degree recipients. Our first student, Akshita Mohan Nayak. Mamta T. Nitya V. Paras Lunia. R. Rajkumar. Samlam Michui. Sapam Tikin Singh. Sneha Rai. One Lal Pecky. Vivin Urio. Vimeo Tepa. Thank you so much, sir. The MSW students, quickly come on stage for a quick photograph. Thank you. our Dean of Social Science and Humanities, Dr. Chetan Bajaj, to give away the degrees. We begin with Ashwati M. Aishwarya Mohandas. Aminat Rishmi Amir. Rishmi has achieved the third rank for this batch. Anita Sumin Joy. Bhuvaneshwari S. Chaitra N. Chittu Elsa Thomas. Grace Priscilla. Hafira T. Jayalakshmi SH. Janita J. Kajari Manisha. Kanchan Gupta. Karidi Venkata Sai Priya. Kartika S. Krishna Priya KP. Mahara Radhika Janak. Miriam Vinu Koshi, who's achieved the second rank in class. Mauna Sudhir Nayak. Nigar Sultana. Prima Anjali Nazari. Rachel Nitya Karat. Renjita Tiyar. Roshni R. Tadaf Amreen. Sakina Akhtar. Saida Hijab Bilgrami. Shilpa Babu. Sona Kinnan. Shishmita M. Tinmini M. Sangma. Sepal Dolkar Yonda. V. Kirtana. Aishat Maza Nizam. I request all the students to kindly come on stage for a quick class photograph. Sir Vahid. Meghna Ji. Sumedha Srikant. Meanwhile, please make sure parents and students, you get your refreshments right at the entrance. Pooja Dikshit. Radhika R. Vasavi VP. And Vedada Indrani. I request all the students of HRDM to kindly come on stage. Stage to give away the degrees. We begin with Aishwarya Gowda B. Anu Tanisha EM. Divya Dilip. Kashif Ahmed. Pallavi MR. Pooja Baker, who's achieved the second rank in class. Ronnie Augustine. Shah Faisal MR. Sylvia Poder. Sneha Dev. Piti Paul. Varalakshmi M. Alright, next Bindu Madhava Tilak. The degrees for the constitutional law students. Bola Shenoy. Chandan DP. Dheeraj K. Shetty. Makbul Ahmed Patil. Memory Marvin. Akhil Murthy. Pradeep Kumar S. Priyanka Bharadwaj. Roshni Katie. Satishwari R. Shreyasi Chatterjee. And Vimrita Sumesh. I request all the students to come on stage for a quick class photograph. Meanwhile, I request the students of Bachelor of Commerce degree recipients to be by the stage. S. Kumar N. Mohammad Jasim. Mohammad Shihad. Preeta R. Rahul Joseph. Sanjana S. Sonia R. Suhas Reddy. Tanuja S. Trishma R. Archana N. Nikhil X. Roshan. Ayad Sharik Ahmed. Abhishek V. Ahmed Abrar Sharif. Before the BCom honors, let's take a quick picture of the class. Ankita Anjana. Ankush A. Aparna Priya M. A Essentia J, of the third rank in class. Farhan Javed. Raghuna S. Gauri Ravindran. Jayashree K. Jonathan Samuel Robert. Mamta R. Merlin R. Mudassir. Mohammed Shaheen. P.R. Sirish. P. Revanth Reddy. Rajesh H.M. S. Tarun Ganesh. Shweta H.S. Shina Raja Manuri. Suhail H.F. Suhas P. Gowda. Sumaya Sultana. Anita Manjunath. Vaseem Basha. Yashwant R. Teja Y. Susan Priyanka D. Shamim Abdullah. Thank you so much, sir. I request our Dean of Social Science and Humanities, Dr. Chetan Bajaj. First one is Azhar Nawaz. Shakila Junaid. Akhil Krishnan. Dimple M. Farheen Sharif. Harshita B. Jatin S. Modi. KK Rashid. Kritika V. Medini Singh. Mehul Kapoor. Mohammad Danish. Mohit J. Talreja. Naguru Jyoti Lata. Neetu Singh Chaudhary. Pavan Kumar. Rajesh M. Rakshita R. Shivani ER. Siddharth VS. Sudarshi MS. Syed Usman Ahmed. Vaishnavi KS. Vaishnavi Rachi Raju. Akshaya Gopalaritam. Syed Niyaz Ali. Yash Chaudhary. I first request the BCom honor student to come on stage for a quick photograph. followed by the BCom ACCA. Ravi Ranjan, Rohit Ambat, Shweta M, Kriti V, I request all the students of BCom to kindly come on stage for a quick class photograph. Alia VP. Arkum. Arvind Kumar, Ashwati S, G. Vignesh, Joseph, Mary Steffi, Mohammed Naman, S. Kumar, Nandu Kumar S, Nirmal Barnabas, Poonam Dogra, Pradeep Jha, Priyanka R, Sharad S. Nair, Sharad S. Nair, Sushma A. Swati R. Syed Muzamil. Tansi TK. Priyanka S. Cynthia Eunice Bhaskar. Mohammed Salman. Shahbaz Shaukat Tali. The BBA students, can they come on stage for a class photograph? Ashley Dinesh. Glinda Melody. Jaydev Janardhan Natesh. Justin Sunny Gregor. Jyoti Jha. Balika V. R. Akash. Taksim. Sheikh Hamida Haider. The BA students, can you come on stage for a photograph quickly? Anuraj. Venkatesh Kumar B. I'd like to call the students of Bachelor of Science Photography. We begin with Abhishek Joshua, Gagan Kumar H. Ishita Mehta, Deepa Kumar. Samarth Kaushik. Shreesh Balsa. Subodhit Ghosh. We now have the students of BSc Sound Engineering, Aditya Nagarajan. Amit Singh. Moses R. Sachin Shishir Holland. Sandeep Ramesh. Shiv Shankar BS. I'd like to call upon the Bachelor of Computer Applications, Aaron Fernandez. Chetan Reddy. Deepak R. Danush M. Hazel Khan. Kumaran G. Manish Raj. Mohammed Faizan, who's achieved the third rank in class. Mohan Goyal. Naresh M. Pranay Vinod. Rohan SP. Sai Meghna. Shweta P. Vishal M. Vikram Sundar K.